People, so let's start. First things first, with our Louisville chili, we're gonna saute some onions. I mixed with my regular onions and shallots, and interesting, I'm making Louisville chili while looking at a documentary about our favorite hometown hero, Muhammad Ali, our most favorite and famous son from Louisville and the Commonwealth of Kentucky. So anyway, what I'm doing is I basically pulverize these onions in my food processor. And first things first is to start sauteing them. So after you saute those, you enter in your garlic. And then I'm going to add my beef and seasonings. As a matter of fact, one thing I like to do is bloom my seasoning. So I'm about to start adding these seasonings first. I'm gonna make a little spice pouch, one moment, with all these seasonings. Okay, so I have created a little spice pack. And now the pot is hot, so we can start blooming. So first things first, I'm going to take this spice pack and start sauteing. Then we'll add the onions. There we go. See that? Already started. Now stir it real quickly because you don't want it to burn. Okay, stirring. Now let's add the onions. Sorry y'all, I wanted to drop it and get the onions in real quick before the spices started to burn. Sorry about that. Okay, so anyway, here we go. So, as you see, there's more water in that, so it's going to take a while to actually cool down the hot. We just bloomed those seasonings. And let's go home and let this raise back up to temperature before we add in the garlic. That'll be the next thing to add. Sometimes I blend the garlic with the onions. Okay, so pause. All right. That's like that. Saute for a minute. Saute. Alright, now let's just add our fresh garlic.
William Farish of the Louisville sponsor, then called Angelo Dundee, the Miami Beach-based trainer Clay had met in Louisville back in 1957.
Okay.
Dundee was known for his calm demeanor during the fight and his gift for patching up bloody boxes. He was well-liked.
The only thing I don't like about the Instapot, in my opinion, is like on this saute setting, you can't really control the heat. This says hot and everything, but I think I could have basically, in my opinion, been done if I had done this in a actual pot, which is what I was going to do. But I wanted to do this, that way after I started, I can just let it go and go on with the rest of my day, go biking or whatever. And so that's why I said, let's do it in the Instapot.
After a 2-day journey by train, Cassius Clay arrived in Miami.
And now I'm gonna make a little beef bouillon to go with that. Just a little bit, a little bit goes a long way. That's probably possibly a little more than I need, so hold on. It's on like a teaspoon or whatever. So I already done put this water in the microwave to basically get it hot. Now I'm going to introduce this and stir it. The jig was home, and that's your beef bouillon. Okay, just keep on stirring. As you see, this is still sautéing. I'm about to stir that a little bit.
None was impressed with Clay. He keeps his hands too low, they agree. He's off balance.
Alright, now we're ready to introduce our meat. That's the thing with this Instapot. You have to keep on stirring, because if you don't, these ingredients will start to stick. I don't feel like my garlic caramelized the way I wanted it to, but that's still alright. There you go. And just break that up on the bottom. Okay. Now, let's add the meat. Let's pause that so I can get my hands to add the meat. Okay, here we go. Now break that up and keep on cooking. So of course I don't need to just film that, but I'll be back once that's ready. In the meantime, while I'm doing that, I'm still working on this bouillon. Alright, gotcha. So I just added a little more beef, better than bouillon, into that water because it was a little mild to me. I just tasted my beef, and it's also tasting a little bland. So I'm going to add some more seasonings to get it right. That's the thing. Like they say, you can always add more seasoning, but you can't take it out. So I'm adding a little more onion powder. A little more of this Bloomer's chili powder base. And a little more garlic powder. A little more chili powder. A little more cumin. The one thing I'm missing is cocoa powder, which is an ingredient in Louisville chili, Louisville style chili, and other chilies too. If you don't believe me, look it up. I'm telling you, it will help. Okay, add a little more white pepper. I haven't even added any salt yet. Let me get that down. So I did that, keep on stirring, but as you see, the beef is done. Now, I'm about to add some peppers and fresh onions. Once you do it this way, I've already caramelized my onions to dissolve into the mixture, but I'm about to add some more onions that will keep their shape. That's how you do that. These are fresh onions, but this pepper is frozen, so that's going to lower my temperature again. Okay, let's pause this and taste the beef again. Gotta work with it. I just add a little more seasoning. See that bottom right there? That's the thing you gotta watch out for in the Instapot. There's an anti-burn sensor, and if it determines something is burning, you'll get an alarm. All right now, and let's add our diced onions and peppers.
I don't draw any blueprints. because it might have died on the front of the building. He knew speaking out of a matter of grace would only harm his child if one day he had his child.
All right. There you go. Now we're ready to start adding our base.
And his father's ever-present anger and racial oppression continued to stir his own conscience.
All right, let's add this base right here. Delicious base out of Louisville, Kentucky. You see in Louisville, this is the style. You see it says add cooked spaghetti, top with cheese, add diced onions, chopped green pepper, and all that stuff while browning meat. So, anyway, let's just add this. This is out of the freezer. Hold on. All right, let's do that. That's going to come down. In the meantime, let's add our beef broth. Look, I still got some, so I got to basically add some water and get that out. So I just added some tomato paste. And I've also changed this over to the bean and chili setting. So I'm stirring in my ingredients. Here's some tomato sauce.
In early February of 1962, Angelo Dundee got a phone call from a promoter at Madison Square Garden.
Can of diced tomatoes, no salt added.
A hard-punching journeyman from Detroit.
And a can of Rotel, diced tomatoes with green chilies.
Clay boasted the sports writers that Banks would fall in the fourth round.
Okay. And then we add a can of beans. Red kidney beans, drained and rinsed. And black beans, also drained and rinsed. Now, let's go ahead and stir that. And let's give a little taste. See if we need to season it some more.
But Clay was knocked down in the first. Dundee was afraid his boxer's career was over before it had really started. Cassius went down, eyes closed, Dundee remembered. But when his butt hit the floor, they opened and lit up.
You have to get knocked down at some point. This final got knocked down, Panics.
About to taste that. Not bad. But still needs more seasoning. Just add a little bit of chili powder, cayenne powder, and oregano.
Little wrote to the leader almost dead and took the name.
And of course, a little bit of salt.
Later, after his release from prison, Muhammad would make him principal minister at Temple Number 7 in Harlem.
All right, add a little more seasoning, some more oregano, some, and a little bit of brown sugar, just a little bit. We got some salt. Stir that in.
If Cassius comes out and says,
now,
I'm a member of the Nation of Islam.
Here's the final part. Add just a little bit of this. Just a little bit. Into that. And let it cook. Now, I usually will leave some this out and then add this later. That way I can add it to my baked potatoes and things like that. But I think I'm just going to add a little bit and still have baked potato and stuff. Just won't eat that much chili on it, so to speak. Or just leave, not have that much pasta in it, so it doesn't make a difference. So break this up, put this in the pot, and then put the top on for about 20 to 30 minutes.
Is at least
All right, here we go. Break that up, put that in.
In September 1962, heavyweight champion Floyd Patterson was scheduled to fight challenger Sonny Liston at Chicago's Comiskey Park.
Okay. Now let's put the top on.
Floyd Patterson was a remarkable fighter because he was a heavyweight champion without being a heavyweight. Patterson had a humility about him, a certain righteousness about him. He appealed to the white middle class, the white sports
fan. Right, here's the funny part. Got this one right. Yeah. This is a little bit tricky, but it works. I always mess up myself trying to get it on. Anyway, let's pause it. All right, here we go. 45 minutes, and we'll check back later.
Who took all the barbs and arrows?
So you gotta scrape that pot, or it'll give a signal. That's what I'm talking about. So now I gotta open the pot and scrape the bottom. All right, y'all. That was about 20, 30 minutes. Let's let the pressure release naturally. And we'll check it back in a few moments. Now, let's see what's going on with this chili.
That guy could hit.
Looks like chili. Smells like chili. But is it chili? Let's see what we got here. Looks like chili. Smells like chili. Does it taste like chili?
Unprepared for Clay's victory, the Louisville sponsoring group rushed to arrange a celebration in Miami Beach. But Cassius Clay had other plans.
Mm-hmm.
After midnight, he headed to the cafe of the all-black Hampton House, where he ate vanilla ice cream. Later, Clay, Malcolm X, all-star
Tastes good.
And singer Sam Cooke.
Do I need more?
Long into the night.
That's spaghetti. Let's see.
22-year-old boxer's future.
Okay. Yep. This is Louisville style chili, y'all.
Everything would be different. He had scaled boxing's highest peak. Would no longer need to campaign for a shot at the title.
Now this is for us freaking some of y'all off. You're like, oh, those damn noodles. Okay. Let's just do a little bit. I don't think I'm ready to
Next
eat
morning,
yet.
He's more subdued. He's the heavyweight champion of the world. New responsibilities have been accorded him.
I'm a real heavyweight champion now.
It's just a little taste. Just a little taste. Now my tea water's ready to make some tea.
He also makes a really important.
Yep. This is it, y'all. I did it right. That's Louisville style chili, y'all. The only thing I'm missing was a little bit of cocoa powder. But I think I hit it right this time. Anyway, I'll do a better presentation later on. I think I might need to go ride my bike, get a little exercise in. But in the meantime, thank y'all for joining with me. And I'll do maybe when it's time to eat, when I get back, I'll do a pretty picture of this. Have a guest that's going to try this, but again, they do not want to be on film, so they like theirs with these twisty things. So here you go, and he got the cheese and the green onion, sour cream, and some crackers. Here's my plate, Louisville style chili.